At the head of Antarctica's Weddell Sea floats an ice shelf the size of California. On its surface stretches endless ice a mile thick. In January 2020, a team of geologists began drilling down into the desolate frozen shelf.
This camp is about 160 miles from the edge of the ice shelf. There's no shelter from fierce polar storms. Even in 24-hour summer sun, it's a bleak place to work.
Conditions below the crushing ice shelf are not believed to support life, and the open ocean only reaches the coastal edge. But hidden below its monumental area, scientists are not so sure what lies beneath. Their goal is to go where few have gone before, where the ocean floor is a barren wasteland that has been entombed by an endless roof of ice for thousands of years.
They're hunting for samples in the seabed to find out what used to be trapped in this Antarctic ice.
What could be down there that can shed new light on how these massive ice sheets affect the Earth? After 20 painstaking hours, the team bores through more than half a mile of ice.
Places where the ice is this thick, it's hard to get to the seafloor. The total amount of area they've explored under there is probably about the size of a tennis court.
To collect the sediment, they need to lower the sample collection kit on a rope through a hole in the ice and all the way to the ocean floor.
But at the bottom, they hit something unexpected that will shatter their understanding of the secret world.
The camera hits a boulder, and it's the only large rock within at least 20 feet. What are the odds? So they've drilled all the way through the ice, right over the one spot where they can't get through to the seafloor.
After a few tense moments, they free the kit from the rock, and the camera swings around the boulder.
Clinging to the boulder are tiny tentacle-like things that look like enoki mushrooms. On the other side are what look like sponge-type organisms. And covering parts of the rock is a thin layer of bacteria known as a microbial mat. It's life.
The existence of life at this spot, so far from the coast, stuns experts. How can sea creatures be living in such an uninhabitable place? After sending a camera down 4,600 feet to the bottom of an ice shelf, Antarctic experts are shocked to find sea creatures living where they thought no life exists, and recognize the larger creatures as types of marine sponge. Beneath other ice shelves, researchers have found rare mobile creatures. But the creatures on this rock can't move. For this reason, they were previously thought to be the first type of organisms to disappear under an ice shelf. What could they possibly feed on?
These sponges and bacteria, they're filter feeders. They rely on phytoplankton and the creatures that eat phytoplankton for food.
Filter feeders eat these microscopic pieces of food suspended in the water by filtering them through gills or a specialized diffusion system in their cells.
But phytoplankton are microscopic plants that need light for energy. And this boulder is 160 miles from any trace of light.
Phytoplankton can't survive here. This severely limits marine ecosystems' chances of survival. So you have to wonder, what is keeping the creatures on this boulder alive?
At the edge of the ice shelf, where the water is shallow, an alien world of sea spiders, sea stars, and urchins carpet the seafloor.
But sunlight more easily penetrates this environment, feeding an entire ecosystem of plants and algae. This, in turn, feeds larger wildlife, like fish, penguin, whales, and seals.
As you travel further under the ice shelf, there's less and less light, and consequently, less and less life. But life in the pitch black isn't totally impossible.
Deep into the Pacific Ocean's Mariana Trench, 26,000 feet below sea level, there is absolutely no light. And water pressure is so intense, human bones would literally implode. And yet, Mariana snailfish still eke out an existence.
Very little can survive, and the ecosystem is very limited at this depth. So what do snailfish eat?
Many marine creatures that live on the seafloor get their nutrients from something called marine snow. When marine creatures die, they sink to the bottom. Along the way, they're eaten by other creatures. Their bodies are torn apart, and they get broken into smaller and smaller pieces.
Eventually, they fall down to the ocean floor, becoming food for other creatures thousands of feet below.
So those snailfish at the bottom of the Mariana Trench are eating marine snow that could have fallen as far as 7 miles.
But fish, urchins, and sea stars, they can move around and find their food. But the sponges on this rock, they're stuck there. They're immobile. Their food has to find them.
And scientists have seen nothing capable of creating marine snow under the ice shelf. How do they survive there?
If nutrients aren't falling from above, where are they coming from? Hoping to shed light on the creature's uncanny survival, they share the video footage with colleagues at the British Antarctic Survey.
So sometimes as a scientist, you have to flip your whole perspective to uncover the truth. So then they have to wonder, if the marine snow isn't falling on the boulder vertically, could it be drifting in horizontally?
The researchers consult maps and pinpoint ocean currents in the Ross Sea capable of carrying marine snow deep under the ice shelf. But some currents are a staggering 930 miles away. In some cases, a single microscopic piece of plankton could take years to travel the distance.
That means the sponges and bacteria on this boulder are being nourished by materials that potentially traveled up to 1,000 miles. It's astonishing.
That's hundreds of times further than most marine snow travels, even in the deepest, darkest parts of the ocean. How does food travel that kind of distance?
As the faraway currents bring warmer seawater further under the ice shelf, the water cools and sinks to the bottom, displacing the seawater that was there before.
And that creates a suction of sorts that moves a slow current that can drag nutrients hundreds of miles to the sponges on this rock.
This accidental discovery is an unexpected reminder that life on Earth can thrive in extremely nutrient-deprived environments.
What other creatures could be hidden beneath the ice shelf of the Weddell Sea? Living in an otherworldly place that was previously thought unable to support life.